All right, special end of the year video, last day of 2013. It's been a good year for me. A lot of bullshit, but a lot of great things happened. And this is special because I got, I got my guitar. I got my camera, so you're gonna see more skate videos from me, special ones, and I have my new phone, and here is my new phone. There, boom. And there's the thing. It's dying. So that is, here is the video. Okay, so this is gonna be, I saved all my movie stubs up till now, not every single one, but a lot of them. I've seen a lot of movies this year. Sorry, hang on. Seen a lot of movies this year, and this is how many movie stubs I have right here. See that? That's a lot. So, this isn't going to be in any particular order, but I'm going to do like a little quick review about them. Just in case you guys don't know what it is or whatever. It's not going to be a long review, like 30 seconds, so this will be a long video, not super long, but yeah, so here we go. Obviously all these I've seen in theaters since I have the movie stub, so alright, so first of all we have, this is a very old one, Zoolander. It's about Derek Zoolander, played by Ben Stiller. His he is a fashion model, runway model. His manager is played by his dad, but not his dad in the movie, his dad in real life. So Hansel is his nemesis, and Will Ferrell is also a fashion designer that tries to thwart and destroy Derek Zoolander's career, basically. Tries to get him brainwashed. So that is Zoolander. It is a fucking fantastic movie, and it's amazing. It's got great one-liners and a lot of great quotes you can think. Then I have Oz, the Great and Powerful. This is played by James Franco. He is Oz, who is supposed to save the land of Oz, the place of which is where Dorothy, Toto go to. So this is in a sense a prequel, but maybe not meant to be a prequel. But it would make sense if you could take it as a prequel. So he needs to defend the witch and save the people, and that's how Oz ends up becoming, if you've seen The Wizard of Oz, that's how Oz becomes that. And then here we go, we have another one. Oops. Vampires Suck. Now I saw this movie with my buddy, and his friend James. It's a spoof about Twilight. It's great. It's got David DeLuise in it. It's a very great movie. I'd never seen Twilight, but it I could definitely tell it was making fun of it, and it was just a really funny movie. So, got that. Then we have The Expendables 2. It has Terry Crews, Chuck Norris, Bruce Willis, Arnold Schwarzenegger, Sylvester Stallone, Randy Kutcher, Jet Li, but he doesn't have as big a part in this. A very, very, very short part, only in the beginning. The movie's shorter, but it is great because that's Chuck Norris, more Schwarzenegger, more Bruce Willis. And, great movie. Now this one, I don't know if you might, it might be kind of hard to see. That is Bourne Legacy. Sorry, it's really faded. Like I said, these are old, and, you know, some of them just were printed shitty, whatever, but that's, Bourne Legacy, I believe, is the one that had, Jeremy Renner in it. The newest Bourne movies, and then we have Men in Black 3. Now, Men in Black 3, this is Will Smith, Josh Brolin, Tommy Lee Jones. Josh Brolin plays a younger K. Will Smith time travels, and then that's what happens. He needs to go and try to find help out K in the past. Now, this is an amazing movie. This was a fucking just fantastic movie, just really fucking good. That, the Avengers. Now, the Avengers, this is Captain America, you have Black Widow, you have Hawkeye. Hawkeye's played by Jeremy Renner, Black Widow's played by Scarlett Johansson, Captain America is played by, what's his name? Thor is played by Chris Hemsworth. I believe Chris Pine plays Captain America. I might be wrong. I'm sorry if I'm wrong. Robert Downey Jr. plays Iron Man. And we have playing Bruce Banner, Mark Ruffalo. They're clashing and they're fighting. This is their first time being together and everything. It's a great fucking movie. Yeah, it's really good. Then we have Paranormal Activity 4. This is takes place after the third one, I believe. The third one is the first in chronological order. The third one is the first one, and the first one's the second one, and then the third one's the fourth. The first one's the The third one's the first one. The first one's the second one. The second one's the last one, and I think that the fourth one is then the third one, something like that. But yeah. Basically, it's the same concept, except a lot of stuff happens, like, over webcam and stuff, because this girl and her boyfriend are talking over webcam. Then we have Transformers 2. Transformers 2, this is, We have Optimus is also Shia LaBeouf. If you don't know Shia, he is who it was in Even Stevens, Holes. Then he has another interest. This one we do. No. We have Megan Fox again. It's another good one. The Decepticons are trying to take over the world, and I think it was one of my favorite ones out of the three. Then we have I Love You, Man. This is Paul Rudd and Jason Segel. Basically, Paul Rudd is, he's not made friends, he's very serious about his job, and, his girlfriend asks him to find some friends. So he finds a friend, played by Jason Segel, and, Jason Segel is, they end up getting close, and they're, like, have an awkward friendship, but they have a good friendship. Um, Alright, they got, yes, I wrote that because you can't see it on there anymore. Mr. Woodcock. Mr. Woodcock, played by Billy Bob Thornton, he is always picked on this one kid. I believe it was played by Sean William Scott. And then it turns out that Mr. Woodcock ends up dating his mom, but Mr. Woodcock always picked on him in high school. Now he picks on him even more because he sees him all the time because he's dating his mom. Now we have... Shit, I don't even know what this one says. I don't know if you'll be able to see it. Kind of faintly. Well, that one's for Underworld Awakening. That is the fourth movie in the Underworld series. Kate Beckinsale, again, she is wonderful, she is beautiful, and in this one, this girl is also a Lycan, but she is very vicious, she's younger. It's very brutal. I didn't really care for the other ones, but this was very brutal. You needed to know the rest of them to understand it. And I believe Bill Nighy is the guy who plays the main head Lycan king. Then we have Casino Royale. This is the first James Bond movie with Daniel Craig. He does a fantastic job. It is a great movie, and yeah. And then we have, you don't mess with the Zohan. Now this is Adam Sandler. He is from the Middle East. He is a spy or something, and he loves to be a hairdresser. All the ladies love him, but he's also like a great, like really ridiculously good spy. So yeah, that's another great one. There's another old one. Tomb Raider. This is the adaptation of the video game. Lara Croft, played by Angelina Jolie. She is a wants to explore tombs. She's very into history, tries to find ancient artifacts, and she has people that deceive her, and she needs to defend herself. Then we have Dan in Real Life. This is another great movie. This is actually, mostly all these are great movies. You have Steve Carell and Dane Cook, I believe. Steve Carell is, what is he? It's a very like real movie. Like, it does, there's no special effects, there's no special lighting. It's a very real movie, and it's really good. He ends up starting to like his girlfriend, no, his brother's like girlfriend or something, but not like her, but like, or maybe that's not exactly it, but he does start to like this girl who she ends up, he's a writer, I believe. So yeah, it's another great movie. You got Pirates of the Caribbean, Stranger on Stranger Tides, and then we have that is Johnny Depp, and you know, the Black Pearl and Captain Tortuga, and yes. So this one, we have another Shia LaBeouf movie right here. No, we don't. I'm just kidding. The Eagle. This was a medieval type of Roman movie about this type of artifact that gave these guys powers. It's really hard to explain. Then we have the original Transformers. This is the first time we see Shia LaBeouf, Megan Fox, Optimus Prime on the big screen, live action. We find out, you know, Sam Witwicky is actually, his parents are, they're kind of strict, and they also are like very clingy, I guess. Like, they don't want to let him grow up. And we got this one, Body of Lies. This is Leonardo DiCaprio. He is fighting terrorists. It's an alright movie. Don't remember too much. Now, then we have the original. Wait, is it upside down? Yes, it is. The original Star Trek movie. This actually has Leonard Nimoy, the original Spock, in it. And it's a great movie. It's also got John Cho, Tony Cho. I don't remember his exact name. The Harold from Harold and Kumar. Now this one, this is only in theaters for like one day, and I was excited to see this one. Tekken Blood Vengeance. This is a CGI Tekken movie. It was great. It focused on Jin and Nina and Anna, and it was I really enjoyed it. Then we have Total Recall, the remake. This has Colin Farrell, Kate Beckinsale, who was incredibly beautiful in it. And then we have what else? Jessica Biel and Bryan Cranston. And then Tony Cho, Harold, otherwise. And then now we got Semi-Pro. This is Will Ferrell. He is a 70s basketball star. This has Andre 3000 in it. He is also great. It's like just a really good movie. Not my favorite, but it was quite good. I love a lot of Will Ferrell movies. The Benchwarmers. This is a loser baseball league with Rob Schneider. John Heder and David Spade. Great, they collaborate great. Wow, this is an old one. This one is almost 10 years old. Alien vs. Predator. This is a fucking great movie. This is where the aliens meet the predators and they both end up attacking the people. It's an intense movie. And I wasn't very familiar with the aliens or the predators, but I enjoyed it very thoroughly. Yes. Then we have another one, Cowboys and Aliens. This had Olivia Munn in it. It had Harrison Ford and a Daniel Craig. Daniel Craig possessed this alien-like device that gave him this extra strength, in a sense, I guess you could say. And they had to fight aliens, and it was a good movie. Now, we have the original Thor. This is Chris Hemsworth, Natalie Portman, Skeleton Skarsgård. Great movie. They find Mjolnir and Agent Coulson wants to protect it, and they try to keep Thor locked up captive, but he's the son of Zeus, son of Odin. What do we got here? I don't know if you can see it. Killer Elite. This is another movie. This is by I'm gonna make this a part video because it's gonna be too long. That is Robert De Niro, some other guys. It's a pretty good movie. Basically these like assassins try to kill each other and stuff. That's the end for this part. I'm gonna make a part 2 and 3 and whatever, and if you're interested in watching them, then you can watch them all. But this is it.